The following is a reading of an article published on ultrarunning.com that I found quite compelling, written by Gary Cantrell, aka Lazarus Lake, race director of the Barkley Marathons, Biggs Backyard Ultra, and the Vol State 500K. When listening to this article, I ask that you substitute the word runner with healthy human. You are listening to the Co-Movement Gym podcast, where we inspire people to move and live courageously. If you are enjoying this content, please support our sponsors in the description. I thank each and every one of you for being on this journey with us. Now, please enjoy the show. Folks, listen up. I want to take a brief moment and thank our podcast show sponsors, Lombardi Chiropractic, Native Path Supplements, and Redmond Life. Lombardi Chiropractic has been my personal chiropractor for 10 years and has kept my body strong and healthy. Native Path Supplements are used by numerous Co-Movement clients and our coaching team here at the facility. I highly recommend that you try their chocolate collagen peptides. I was made aware of Redmond Life by one of our trainers here at the facility. He recommended I try Relight Electrolyte Powder. This supplement has dramatically improved my afternoon energy levels and overall hydration. I'd like to thank these three companies for providing outstanding service and products that make our society healthier and more resilient. Mention the Co-Movement Gym podcast when you call Lombardi Chiropractic, and not only will they treat you like family, they will provide a nice enticing discount to all listeners. And use code COMO15, that's COMO15, at checkout when shopping at nativepath.com or redmond.life and receive 15% off all your orders. Your support to our show sponsors assists in us paying for expenses and continuing to provide content we hope you all enjoy. The Heart of a Champion by Gary Cantrell. The greenest novice to the most seasoned veteran. As ultra runners, each of us has an ambition of reaching our potential. Whether our goal is to simply achieve a finish at a distance we have never before reached, to complete a signature race, run our personal best time, or even to set records and win championships, we are always seeking information that will allow us to improve our performances. It is only natural that we look for guidance from the people who excel at the sport. In emulating the great runners, we seek to find the greatness within ourselves. However, we soon discover that emulating the paths that others follow to success is not easy. Studying the methods of champions can be more confusing than enlightening. To begin with, their training regimens are likely beyond our reach. What real benefit is there in trying to adapt training programs that fall outside of our ability to perform? We can scarcely run repeats at a pace that we cannot even maintain for the first rep. There is likely to be not enough hours in the day for the average runner to match the mileage totals that these athletes log. While there seems to be an unlimited variety of perfect diets, a look at the practices of the people we would emulate reveals no real common thread. One man's staple is another's poison. And many great runners seem to have no dietary philosophy at all. From supplements to shoes, hydration to heart monitors, form to fuel, there seems to be nothing that can be credited as a single secret to success. What is it we are to do? During my own nearly 40 years in this sport, it has been my privilege to get to know many great runners from multiple generations. Over that span of time, the sport has seen a myriad of changes. Runners of today would be hard-pressed to recognize the ultras of 35 years ago. Even the handful of races that have survived over the entire span are scarcely recognizable as the same events. However, I have found among the great runners, discovered a single common thread. They all seem to share one attribute that might well be the source of their ability to attain the most that their potential allows. The real secret of the great ones is not physical. It is within their minds. It is not, certainly, personality. Successful ultra runners range from affable and gregarious to taciturn and antisocial. Some compete with a smile and a laugh. Others grim their face with determination. It is not even competitive drive, although there is no denying that this is important when the competition is close. Some runners run to compete with others, while other runners run to compete with themselves. It is not even the love of running in some cases. There have been notable champions of the sport who only compete to compete and train because it is a means to an end. The key attribute, which seems to transcend all other variables, is resiliency. The great ones from across the decade have all exhibited this single characteristic. We all know that every ultra in which we seek to perform at our best contains a lion's share of up and downs. Running at the margin of our ability pretty much guarantees there will be moments of difficulty. For some runners, those difficulties never seem to engender doubt. I have been consistently amazed over the years by the severity of issues that some runners can seemingly take in stride. No matter how many times some people are knocked down, they always get back up. No matter the severity of the problems that they might face, the great ones are only thinking of how to move past them. No mental energy is wasted on wondering if they can go on. Resiliency extends beyond a single race. Not only are the great ones undeterred by issues within a race, coming up short in a single event does not carry over into the next. Of course, that resiliency does not come from nowhere. There is a second characteristic that all great runners share. Really, the great athletes in every sport share it. Pride. Not the pride of boasting of what they have done or seeking attention, but an inner pride of how they conduct themselves as athletes. Great runners take pride in how they prepare and how they compete. They cannot simply give up because they've set a standard for themselves and that does not allow it. The good thing about the real secrets of the great ones is that we can emulate them. We might not be able to achieve the same results, but we can compete to the same standard. My greatest satisfaction as an ultra running athlete did not come during the days so many years ago when I was in what passed for my prime. It has come during the waning days of my career when I finally sought to achieve the true success of conducting myself in the sport as the champions do. Every time out, the measure of my success is not time or distance. It is a matter of having prepared to the best of my ability, set goals that demanded the absolute limit of my ability, and set out an unwavering pursuit to those goals. Like everyone else, sometimes I succeed and sometimes I fail. But if I can walk or limp off the field of battle, knowing that I have done my best, I walk away with a sense of victory.